going on, YouTube's Moose78 back at you with another episode of Stories from the Road. We are on episode number 14. Hope everyone's doing well today, by the way. We are continuing our trip up to Elko, Nevada. We departed from San Francisco the last episode. So far, we're having a pretty good trip. And if you're new to the channel, what this is just my Let's Play series. I just talk about some in-game stuff, some stuff that's going on within the American Truck Sim community, and I'll also throw in a lot of random discussion, just stuff that I find kind of interesting at the time that I sit down and record these. Sometimes we'll talk about just general gaming news, hardware news, just whatever. And if there is a topic you would like to discuss or you'd like me to discuss, leave a comment down below. Love hearing from you guys. And I'm in neutral. Why am I in neutral? Pretty cool scenery. What? Yeah, the truck in front of me didn't stop. And I thought it gave me the red light, so I don't think I needed to stop. Eh, whatever. It's kind of silly to have to stop at a weigh station when it's actually at a gas station. But just a quick recap what we talked about the last episode. Really didn't have too many topics to discuss. We did talk a little bit about the Arizona DLC. Had some gremlins a couple weeks back, about a week or so back actually. Some Windows updates kind of wrecked some stuff. Had to reinstall the G27 software, had to reinstall the Track IR software. Got my shifter set up to an actual 13 speed now, so everything's working out pretty good. Adjusted some sensitivities, so everything's running pretty good now, handling pretty good. Made it a little bit more enjoyable to shift and stuff now, so liking that. Now, at the time that I'm sitting down to record this, the open beta has not yet been released. So if what we're talking about today is a little bit dated, that's why, so apologize for that if that is indeed the case. Doing good on fuel, so we're not going to worry about stopping. We're just going to keep on rolling up towards Elko. But definitely excited to get my hands on the Arizona DLC, the open beta anyways. Just ready to explore some new roads and make those long runs from, say, up around Hornbrook, California, down to the southeastern corner of Arizona. Those should be a lot of fun. Check out the Grand Canyon, see what that has to offer. Check out all the new roads. But one thing I kind of want to discuss today is the new feature, and that is the advanced trailer coupling. And that's definitely caused a little bit of a buzz within the community. Some people are for it, some people think it's an absolute waste. I'm kind of, No, I'm glad it's in the game, but I don't view it as an upgrade. To me, it's a fix. The way reversing and backing up and hitching up to a trailer in all the SES games that I've played has always been a little bit janky. In that you don't have to have the fifth wheel exactly centered with the kingpin to be able to attach the trailer. You could be a mile off, still attach, and be absolutely fine. It's been that way at least since hauling. Probably back to PTM, hell, probably even back to Across America. I actually found my Across America disc the other day, and I thought about installing that and maybe uploading some footage of Across America just to kind of go back and see the things that it did right and compare it to what's going on in ATS right now, so that might be something coming down the road, so be on the lookout for that. Oh, damn. Woo! Hee-hee! Holy damn. Come on, you damn it all! Damn it all! I suck at life. Oh. I'm just gonna coast down and crash. Everything, dear sweet Jesus, why? Stop! Crazy bastard. Okay, the truck's got a mind of its own at this point. Good God. This is why we can't have nice things, guys. This is exactly why. Okay, parking brake is engaged. Yeah, that's a doozy right there.
A few moments later.
All right, we are all reset there after that horrendous event. We are just about to the destination. Somewhat safe and sound. Turn in here, drop this thing off. Yeah, after the way this trip started out, I'm not even going to attempt to back that thing in. Excellent. Even though I caused holy hell. And I'm not sure if I've said this or not, but I am so ready for trailer ownership. Just throwing that out there. Okay. Check El Freight Marketo. Oh, nice. Short run. Take it. Unless there is something else. Why aren't the pictures showing up? Let me back it up and go back into it. It's weird. Very weird. Let's do this. Let's go, well, that's probably like a flatbed or something. Since it's going to bitumen. But that's a Wabash going to Plasters and Suns, so, Yeah, we'll take that, I guess. Kind of a short run. Plus, hit a couple new towns on the way. Wells and McGill. Offer expires in an hour and 45 minutes. I think we can do that. I'm not sure if you guys will hear it in the background or not, but there is construction going on outside my house. So, not sure if that's gonna audio's gonna pick that up or not, but if you hear screaming in the background, that's what that is. Yeah! I'm just glad I could stop this thing now without killing it. That's a pretty good feeling. And forget the fact that, you know, I had one hell of an accident to start out the video this week, but, yeah. As I keep saying, progress, kids, progress. Get your Napa Auto Parts out of my way. Things to do. Bills to pay. Alright, that rhymed and that sounded kind of lame. I apologize. Oh. Wonder what those people were saying back there. They were cops. And again, I'm liking this Map Pro map, but it is just kind of weird as hell. Picking up freight at a fast food place. Get a good look at the exterior of the tractor. Really liking the 579 with the Epic side skirt package. Looks nice and clean. Not too shabby for a aero truck. And am I able to clear that? The trailer? Activate the powers of the track IR. Oh yeah, we got that. But I can't make a corner. No good, buddy. But kind of pick up to where what we were talking about there a few minutes ago before I got sidetracked and, you know, killed half the damn map. Arizona DLC is coming up pretty soon, if it's not out already. And we were talking about the advanced coupling feature. Like I said, to me, that's just kind of a fix. I'm glad they did it. Like I said, that's been in the game since, like I said, probably all the way back to the PTM days, at least the Holland days, but if not across America, where you could be pretty far off and still hook up to the trailer no problem. But I do like how they are making it an optional feature, and you don't have to. It's, you know, not something that's going to be forced on you. You can uncheck it in the options menu. But a lot of people are upset because they think it's taking time away from, you know, map development and things like that. And I really don't think that's the case. I know I made this point a couple videos back, and they have a team that's dedicated to just the maps and stuff like that. So I don't think this is taking any kind of development time away from anything. I'd imagine this was probably a pretty simple thing to implement. But some of the videos I've seen on it does not look like it's going to affect any modded trailers, just modded trucks. So if you've downloaded trucks that are not stock SES, 71,000, too shabby. But if you've downloaded non-SES mods for trucks, you're either going to have to go and update that yourself or wait till the author updates that truck to be compatible with the advanced coupling feature. But if you have modded trailers in the game and you're using an SES truck, looks like you're going to be golden, no issues. Now that could change with the open beta, that could change with the full-on release of the Arizona DLC. But from what I've seen, that's the way it looks so far. And I don't have any non-SES trucks in the game yet, so should be good to go once the beta drops, so pretty happy about that. Girl. Whoa, Nelly. Yeah, the more I shift now with this actual 13-speed setup, really wanting to get that SKRS shifter. What I'm using now for my high-low splitters are the paddles on the side of the G27, like the handbrakes. Which, it's okay. I mean, it works. Can be a little bit cumbersome when you're making a turn and try to grab gears and shift and all that fun stuff. But with that shifter, it just kind of adds another layer of realism. But back to the subject of ATS, Arizona DLC, and features and whatnot. I kind of want to do a video on some... I know we've talked a little bit about it. You know, with trailer ownership, that's definitely a feature everyone wants. But I really want to get your guys' feedback on some features you want to see in upcoming DLC. Kind of one I would love to see, I don't think we really talked a whole lot about, is animated trailer lines, airlines and whatnot. That would be pretty cool. That to me would be a worthwhile feature to sink some time and effort into. You know, you hook up, because now the way they have it with the advanced coupling, you know, the trailer legs go up, and if you're using a stock SES trailer, the handle there that cranks the trailer legs up and down actually moves. So it'd be kind of cool also when you connect to a trailer, the airlines actually connect to the trailer, and when you move around corners or you move your truck anyway, the airlines and everything are animated and move a little bit too. To me, that'd be a pretty cool feature. But leave a comment down below, and we'll get that in an upcoming video for sure. You guys do a pretty good job of interacting, so I'm sure you'll come up with some great suggestions. Look forward to seeing those. Still average about 5.2 miles per gallon, so not too shabby, I guess. Been pulling pretty heavy the last couple loads, so I'll take that. So that load we delivered to Elko, we were grossing about just shy of 80,000. We were 78,000 and change. Two cops passing me now. Okay, it's good. They can pass me, just as long as they don't stop me. Coming up on McGill. Another new town discovered. Pretty cool little town. Nice addition. Need to check and see if there's been any updates to the Map Pro map by Heavy Alex. Not checked for a couple weeks, so I don't know if they've got anything updated. But really enjoying this map mod. Links are down in the description for all my mods. Here comes the train. Thought I was gonna kill it there. And these cops are not messing around. They're passing everybody. And starting to see the destination pop up there on the mini. Stopped about a mile short there, so GG. Go, 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 you pickle weasels. And hopefully one thing they implement in future updates are actual turn lanes where you get a turn arrow. So you're not constantly fighting traffic to turn left and all that good stuff. Oh, that's cool. The old AC/DC dollar bill from Money Talks. Very cool. Here we are, Plaster and Sons. Hello! Feeling sassy. I wouldn't think it'd be too hard. This is a fairly big yard. Pop out here in the external view so we can find where they want this thing at. Over there. Let's see. I wonder if I can drive around here. Oh yeah, you can drive around. Bring it on around. Wonder if that has a collision. Or if I can just drive straight on through that. We shall see. Moment of truth is upon us. No whammies. No whammies. I got a feeling there's going to be a collision on this and we're not going to be able to drive through it. Yep. Still, it shouldn't be too hard to back this into. See if I can't redeem myself from a couple weeks ago and from one of my gameplay videos. Where I look like a monkey football trying to back up. By crikey. Oh, welcome to Redemption. Population this guy. Woohoo! Backed it in perfectly on the first try. Not too shabby for a pickle weasel like me. Alright guys, I think I have kept you long enough for today. If you liked today's video, go and like and share it. It just helps me out a bunch. If you're new to the channel and not already subscribed, please consider doing so now. And be sure to check in next time for another episode of Stories from the Road. Be sure to check in on Wednesdays for some just plain old gameplay footage. But that's going to wrap it up for today, guys. Take care. We'll be seeing you. Hey guys, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed this video. Please take a moment and subscribe to my channel. Also, if you want to follow me over on the Twitters, click on the link in the description. And if you're looking for great gaming gear at an affordable price, click my NoScope affiliate link also down in the description. And if you want more ATS content, click on the video to check out my Stories from the Road playlist. Thanks, and we'll catch you in the next one.